Hello YouTube, chills, bit of the old G&T with a slice of lemon, what? Need something to gird the old loins before work tomorrow. But here we are, discussing Google Plus, as many other people have been doing. So you're probably asking, with all this being said, what the heck does little old me have to add to the conversation? Well, this is nothing new. I've looked at getting off YouTube before, but as was said by the way of the pastor in his video, YouTube was where the action was. But I think this is more serious than it has been in the past. For those of us in the industry, we've been watching Google's progress with, well, interest in the beginning. And later on, yeah, the sense of resignation, I suppose. When Google first started, the behavior of the big corporates was well known. You know, everybody was pretty much had enough of them, which is why when Google turned up on the scene with their catchphrase of do no evil and telling the community, look, we're here for you, we're on your side, it was no surprise that people flocked to them, and they ended up bagging all the a good chunk of the advertising revenue, and they opened their doors to the community with a load of promises, and the community fell for it, and including me, and crowded through their doors, and the sheer number of us have basically led to Google having the kind of position they enjoy today. But this was not going to last. Indeed, I recall a distant memory of a report when Google took over YouTube of one of their executives saying, how the heck would we keep hold of our do no evil mantra if we took over YouTube? And I think that is pretty much proven to be the point. They can't. They haven't been able to. Slowly, their mantra of being the people's supplier, for want of a better word, has gone by the board. They know that they cannot survive on advertising revenue alone, that advertisers are fickle beasts, that technology is now moving on at such a pace that advertisers are going to shift. And to that degree, they have broadened out. They've gone into hardware. They took over, I'm pretty sure it's Google that took over Motorola and acquired a load of patents and other associated stuff like that. So, you know, the days of free were going to be over at some point. I mean, even with all Google's money, once the do no evil mantra had been broken, which is pretty much what happened when they took over YouTube initially, it stood to reason that things were going to get worse. And that they were going to become a monolith, and it was only going to be a matter of time. And that is indeed what seems to have happened. So, before I continue on, if you are interested in the kind of things that I say, the kind of things that I write, in actually watching or reading my opinion, there's going to be two links in the hoo-ha bar. One to my Vidler channel, and the other one is to my main domain. You might want to bookmark those and keep hold of them sooner rather than later, because now there's a rumor going around, and I haven't found very much to substantiate it yet. That said, I haven't done that much digging on the issue, that come the 18th of November 2013, that Google are going to tighten their policies in terms of copyright infringement. Among the communities that are most up in arms in this are the gaming communities, because that threatens things where gaming music is part of the channels. And let's face it, if Google were to suddenly go through a channel with years worth of content, the number of strikes that could potentially be brought against a channel could wipe it out. This is one of the reasons why I find it difficult to believe that rumour. Google would lose so much faith. I mean, they initially came and said, "We are the people's supplier. We are the people's corporation here. We're on your side." And it's bad enough that they're doing what they're doing. It's understandable. They have to make money. And the number of people on YouTube, the number of hours of video that's uploaded every minute on a global scale, that must cost a lot of money because they've got edge servers all over the place, all over the planet, which is why Google videos enjoy such a fast download compared to other places, to other services, because they have the videos copied to edge servers all over the place, which nobody else can match. No other provider is going to be able to match that. It costs money, and they're subsidizing the entire video community. It was only a matter of time before something like this was going to happen. They were going to reach critical mass and have to work out that, hey, folks, we're going to actually have to tighten our rules to cut down on the kind of stuff that people are uploading, and we're going to have to get rid of some of the channels that are just, skating near the edge. But I find it, that is bad enough. If they were to adopt a stance which would deploy a technology which would wipe out vast swathes of channels overnight, that I think would be too much even for them. they'd have to be dumb if they did it, but I wouldn't put anything past him. Because Google's technicians and engineers lately do seem to have been deploying changes which, I reckon they haven't thought them out. I reckon they haven't thought them through, or if they've thought them through, they've only thought them through from one viewpoint, and they haven't thought about these changes from other viewpoints before they've deployed some of this technology and some of these changes. And I think that if they do deploy something so draconian, I think it would be done because they didn't think of the consequences properly before they deployed it. And by that time, they would have lost so much. That would be a step too far. I think that the majority of the YouTube community would just go. So I don't think that on the 18th that they would be so draconian on channels. I think if they were to do something like that, they'd have to have an amnesty. But we shall see. They have done stupid things before. Some of these things that they're having to do are not down to them. The law is finally catching up with the internet. It's still a few years off behind, but it is starting to catch up, and copyright content was always going to be an issue. I've tried to get off YouTube before. I reawakened my Vidler and Vimeo accounts, and the uploads are 2010. That was how long ago it was. And the way of the pastor is perfectly right. I came back because this was the only, YouTube was pretty much the only gaming town, but things have changed from that point. I don't think that the way of the pastor has perhaps thought about the sheer degree of these changes. Everybody's got their price, and I think that now the YouTube impositions are a price which is too high for many people, including me, to pay. They would reach, to put it in his terms, if you go to the Way of the Pastor's channel, he's got a video there, it's worth a watch. At some point there would have been, in his terms, such a degree of profanity on Channel 6 that people would have left and gone to Channel 11. They would have enacted what they'd threatened if it was bad enough. And I think that YouTube is now getting that bad. So, yes, the upshot is that Google Plus is a load of crap. And this is another reason why I think that I'm not exactly writing off the 18th of November as a complete joke, because Google Plus felt to me like it had been designed from one viewpoint, with a complete failure to account from the many other viewpoints that are out there and the many other ways that people use a service. Which is why I hated it. It's crap. And Google should not be surprised at that. It does surprise me that Google have not taken that on board. They should have sat down and think, okay, what is it about this service that people do not want to flock to it? If they want people on it, they should be offering a service that people want to join, not a service that they have to force people onto by threatening the removal of other facilities. If you don't have a Google Plus account, then you can't do X, Y, and Z. You know, they've gone about this completely the wrong way, which is why I'm not writing off the 18th of November as a complete joke. And that's why those two URLs are down below, and why I urge you to, if you are interested in the kinds of things that I say and write and opinion and all the rest of it, and you do want to, people ask me questions, and I try and cover them. You guys know that I haven't got a lot of time on my hands because of this project, and it's got another 6 months to run, potentially a bit longer. But, you know, if you do keep a track of things, because right at the top of the msknight.com site is the links to the various channels. I have yet to put the Vidler channel on there. But going forward, this kind of thing was going to happen. We cannot expect a free ride. That's why I pretty much paid for my domain from the outset. And actually, the value for money that I've had from that has increased over the years. I mean, the amount of space that I've had has increased. The facilities that I have increased. I can do video streaming from my own bleeding web space in California, for crying out loud. You know, I look back at when I first joined CompuServe back in the mid-90s, and I think, good grief, wow. You know, jeepers. I'm about to run out of gin and tonic. This is serious. This free service from YouTube, / Google, could not happen. Could not be maintained forever. Certainly, Vidler and Vimeo also have their restrictions for the free basic service, which I have to admit that I will be adhering to. I'm not sure what the current terms are, whether it's certain lengths of video or a certain amount of upload per month or per week or something, I don't know. Certainly Vimeo, I certainly managed to find their terms easily, and they said no gameplay videos, which is going to be a bit naff for the Minecraft stuff. We don't know. We couldn't expect a free ride for forever. This was doomed to happen. I wouldn't mind if Google Plus actually benefited my life, but it doesn't. The function on Google Plus is rubbish. That's why I don't want it. I mean, we've witnessed the... if you've been following the IT press, you'll know this, but if you don't follow the IT press, you wouldn't know that Google have long been engaged in a battle of the numbers with Facebook. You know, the Facebook and MySpace thing, Facebook won. Google are trying to pit Google Plus against Facebook in the numbers game, as in the number of active members. And if they can get a legitimate active member number figure from forcing all their subscribers of all their services onto Google Plus, then that will give them the numbers game edge by which they can then proclaim, hey folks, we're the number one, come to us. But I think that they underestimate a good portion of the population. I hardly ever post on Twitter. I hardly ever post on Facebook. As much of my history as possible has been deleted from those services. I'm not sure. I know I had a MySpace account at some point. I know I had an Orkut account at some point. These things are floating around in the ether. But everything is now starting to come under my control. My blogs are off Blogger. They are now on my domain. We need to, if you are serious about taking things forward, if you are serious about publishing your material in a certain space, you can do it. There are services there. You might have to pay a little for it. And by a little, I mean, what is my domain service costing me? I think the whole service is costing me something like £10 a month, which some people will find onerous, especially in these days of austerity and high unemployment, even in the developed countries. But the only thing that YouTube gave was a community. You could search for things. It was like a central point. I mean, it's like having a shop. It's great having a good value for money shop offering good quality product if nobody knows that you're there. And that's what the YouTube community offered. Indeed, that's what the Google search engine offered. Indeed, the Google search engine, when I try various engines now and then, does seem to be one of the most, if I'm looking for something, Google search engine will give me what I'm looking for within the first page or two. Having said that, I know that there are other things out there that are being buried. In 2000, 2001, that kind of era, if you typed my name into Google, you would find me. I would typically be number one on the search results. Now I'm not even on page 11 or 12 or something because somebody else with a misspelt name has, Michelle with a single L. Is now taking over because they paid for advertising. Who knows? I don't care anymore. So if you look for my name, you won't find me easily. That can be as much as a blessing, as much as anything else, but that's how Google roll. If you pay for the advertising, you will get the preferred ranking, and those of the rest of us will not. So over time, that is how Google have changed over the last 15 years. And obviously, when the other Michelle Knight hit the press from the US kidnapping, I am nowhere to be seen. But it's down to the community now. There are other alternatives springing up. This stalemate will not last for too long. I reckon by the end of 2014, there will be another service that says, "Hey folks, we're on your side," and people will once more flock to them. Google will then take a nosedive. They will become an also-ran. Things are different now. Things are different now in the IT sphere to what they were 10 years ago. It sounds, I know for mobile phone, for example, this channel is the only thing now that I have left on Google. I'll be leaving Android in about a month for Yola, and this YouTube channel will be it. My blogs are off. I'm even off. Well, I've got some stuff on Flickr, but Flickr is not the source where most of my photos land now. Things are changing. Things are changing. Other services will arrive, and people eventually there will be a service that people trust, and they will go there. And when they go there, YouTube will be left to the pretty much the mass market stuff that is flooding the rest of the media. The discussion will move on, we will breathe again. It'll take us a while to get there. So, in conclusion, Google have slit their own throats. The community in general is moaning about you, about Google and YouTube, in such a fashion because of the way that Google presented themselves to the community, opened their doors, and then slammed them in the community's face. With pretty much most other corporations, we knew we were dealing with money-grabbing people from the outset, so it wasn't any great surprise when things happened. With Google, it bites people that much more. But there are alternatives out there. The scene has changed. The game has changed. Those of us who are publishing, those of us who want to engage in discussion and not just swallow endless videos about cats or the entertainment sphere, really, we will move on. There will be platforms for us to move to. But in the short term, we might have to suffer limitations on the amount that we can upload on a regular basis. And we will also suffer limitations because we will have to suffer the adverts and other money-making necessities to support the platform on which we voice our opinions, which Google stumped up the money for so long. Hang on in there, folks. We're getting there. But as come the 18th, who knows? I guess if you're still watching this past the 18th American time of November 2013, then I guess either YouTube granted an amnesty or changed their mind, I don't know, or they actually looked before they leapt and did the statistics before they started pulling the plugs on people's accounts. Personally, given Google's and YouTube's behaviour, I wouldn't like to call that one either way. Time will tell. Take care, YouTube, and I'll see you either on my domain, the Vidler account, or here. Who knows? Take care of yourselves, and good luck. Bye.